A PPI is a proton pump inhibitor. You may know it as omeprazole, lansoprazole, pantoprazole, and anything else that's ending in zole. It's one of the most commonly prescribed medications in the world, and it's used to neutralize your stomach acid. Now, if you didn't know, your stomach is full of some pretty strong acid, hydrochloric acid in fact, and it helps to break down any food that goes into it. Now, you release about 1.5 liters of acid into your stomach every day, so fun fact, a few people follow the alkaline diet, but that doesn't work because your stomach just acidifies everything that goes into it. So that diet probably only works from about here to here. Never mind. So anyway, PPIs. Why do you need it? Well, you need it if you need to neutralize stomach acid. Now, the most common reasons a doctor might prescribe that drug is number one, dyspepsia. That's indigestion, but ongoing indigestion, so a feeling of bloatedness and nausea. Most of us get it at some point, but it's often tied into number two or three. So number two, reflux. That's when acid escapes your stomach and starts burning your throat. You might have heard of this as heartburn or GORD or GERD. And sometimes it can go quite high, and that can cause a cough. Now, being overweight, smoking, drinking, having spicy foods, that can make it worse. Number three, gastritis. Itis just means inflammation, so this is inflammation of your stomach lining. It can be caused by booze, smoking, painkillers, bacteria, and even stress. Now, that inflammation gets rid of the protective layer in your stomach, so your acid starts burning your stomach lining. If that gets really bad, it leads to peptic ulcers. So ulcers are like those things when you bite your lip. But if they get really bad, they can punch through your stomach, and that can be really serious. And number four, a few rare conditions where either the reflux has gotten so bad that it's leading to a change in cell type in your throat, known as Barrett's esophagus, or other ones where, for whatever reason, you're secreting too much acid. How does it work? Well, it neutralizes your stomach acid. Don't worry, you can still digest things because there's still a bit of acid in there, and you also release other chemicals that help you digest. Now, the way acid is secreted is complicated, but if you're interested, I'll go into that a bit later. But basically, at a chemical level, hydrochloric acid is HCl, hydrogen and chloride. Now, these ions are released separately into the stomach where they join up, form the acid, and start digesting everything. The H of HCl is hydrogen, or by itself a hydrogen ion, that's H+. A hydrogen ion is also called a proton. Now, this doesn't just float into the stomach, it's pumped into it. So a PPI, proton pump inhibitor, how does that work? Well, it blocks the pump, stopping the hydrogen getting into the stomach, and that stops your acid forming. Now, PPI is given in an inactive form, and it becomes activated by the acid, and it irreversibly binds to those pumps. At low doses, it probably has an effect for a couple of days. As the dose goes up, that might last for a bit longer. Side effects. Well, there's not many. This is a pretty safe drug. Some people have nausea, headaches, occasionally rashes, and you know, they can talk to their doctor about changing medications if that's the case. Very rarely it'll cause low sodium, but you'll probably know about that if that happens to you. As always, if you don't feel right when you're taking a drug, talk to your doctor. Now onto the geeky stuff, so goodbye most of you, but please do subscribe before you go. But for those of you who want to stick around, here's the history and the pharmacology. That's two sections which I'm putting in because most people, even a lot of doctors, don't know where these drugs came from or what they do to you. So, the history. Well, in the late 1960s, a pharmaceutical company called Hassel decided to start a GI research division with the aim of finding a drug to block stomach acid. In 1972, they began to strike a little bit of gold because another company had found a compound which stopped the secretion, but it was very toxic. This compound had a thioamide group on it, which is nasty stuff and was killing all the dogs they were testing on. So the Hassel guys got rid of that by locking it in a chemical ring system. As with all science, a bit of trial and error until they eventually hit a winner, a compound called a benzimidazole, H123/26. Catchy name, okay, but it stopped secretion. Yeah, oh, hang on a second. Turns out a Hungarian company had already discovered this and were using it to treat TB. No! But our cunning team found a metabolite of H123/26, which the Hungarians hadn't discovered. Hello, timoprazole. It worked, yeah. Oh, no, not quite. It did cause some thyroid problems. No! But about the same time, scientists had discovered the H+, K+, ATPase pump, which is in the stomach, otherwise known as the proton pump. Remember that? And they realized that omeprazole was blocking it. So studying the action at the pump, they could almost concentrate that chemical. And that was compound they called H168/68, even more catchy. But they also called that omeprazole. And it didn't cause thymus or thyroid problems. Well, hey, as celebrations, and it worked. Over time, that chemical has been tweaked and twisted to form other variations of PPI that you'll see, but they're all very much based on the same thing. So how does it work in a bit more detail? Well, to understand this, we kind of need to understand how acid is produced in your stomach. Like all things in your body, it's not simple. It's a glorious medley of a lot of processes all coming together. And they come together around two main things. The H+K+ ATPase pump, or the proton pump, which is in the, number two, parietal cells of your stomach. So when you eat food, smell food, taste it, and see it, it sends nerve signals to get your digestive juices going. That's done by the vagus nerve, which stimulates a few things, one of which is your parietal cells. Once food is in your stomach, it stretches it, causing a bunch of other receptors to fire and stimulate parietal cells even more. Starting at the beginning, the vagus nerve and a hormone called gastrin whack into a cell that's next to the parietal cells. This causes the release of histamine and more gastrin, and these bind to receptors on the parietal cell. This causes them to release calcium, which activates protein kinases, which activates the pump. But what goes through the pump? Well, an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase causes carbon dioxide to bind with water to form carbonic acid, but that breaks down immediately into bicarbonate and hydrogen ions, or protons. Now, these protons go to that pump and they're pushed through. And as they get pushed through, potassium comes the other way, a bit like a revolving door. That helps the process a bit, but basically this is still a really energy-rich thing that your body has to do. Meanwhile, chlorine, which is banging around anyway, slips out through a chlorine channel, and then the two come together in the stomach to form glorious hydrochloric acid. Voila! Now, the PPI directly inhibits the pump. As I said before, they're inactive when you swallow them, but as they get close to the parietal cell membrane, they get protonated by the strong acid environment that's right next to the cell. So this activates them, and they covalently link irreversibly to the proton pump and stop it working. And there you go, PPIs, awesome little drugs which stop your stomach producing acid so that you feel better after a curry. Lots more drug explainers in the series and on this channel, so see you next time, like, subscribe, and toodaloo.